In this video, we will calculate the pressure drop in a pipeline and also the shear stress on the wall. Let us see a problem. An oil of viscosity 0.1 Newton second per meter square and relative density 0.9 is flowing through a circular pipe of diameter 50 mm and of length 300 meters. The rate of flow of the fluid through the pipe is 3.5 liters per second. Find the pressure drop in a length of 300 meters and also the shear stress at the pipe wall. So first let us see what are the data given in this question. First, the viscosity is given as 0.1 Newton second per meter square and the relative density is given. Relative density is nothing but our specific gravity. So if you know the specific gravity, if you multiply that specific gravity by density of water, you will get the density of that particular fluid. So here the relative density is 0.9, the specific gravity is 0.9. And density of water is 1000 and that will give 900 kg per meter cube of density of this fluid, of this oil. Then the circular pipe is having a diameter of 50 mm. Generally we will substitute everything in meters, so it has to be converted into 0.05 meters. 3 decimal should be shifted. The length of the pipeline is 300 meters and the volume flow rate, that is rate of flow of fluid through the pipe, that is Q is equal to 3.5 liters per second. We know that 1000 liters is equal to 1 meter cube. So we have to shift 3 decimals. So 0.0035 meter cube per second. Pressure drop we have to find. Then we have to find the shear stress at the pipe wall. Let us get into the problem. Before solving this problem, we have to calculate whether this flow is laminar or turbulent. If the flow is laminar, we can use Hagen-Poiseuille's equation. If the flow is turbulent, we have to use Dassey-Weisbach equation that we have to see later. So first let us check whether the flow is laminar or turbulent using Reynolds number. Reynolds number is equal to rho Vd by mu. So rho is 900 kg per meter cube. So here we don't know the velocity. So instead of velocity, we have discharge. So using the discharge Q, we can calculate the velocity. Q is equal to AV. Therefore, V is equal to Q by A. Discharge by area, cross-sectional area. Therefore, velocity is equal to 1.782 meter per second is not mentioned here. Okay. So now we have to use the Reynolds number calculation. 900 kg per meter cube, 1.782 meter per second velocity, 0.05 meters diameter and 0.1 newton second per meter square viscosity. So if you substitute these values, you will get the Reynolds number of 801.9 something. So as the Reynolds number is less than 2000, the flow is laminar. So we can use Hagen-Poiseuille's equation for calculating the pressure drop. So let us write the Hagen-Poiseuille's equation. So if you are new to Hagen-Poiseuille's equation, watch the video suggested there. So 32 mu u dash. U dash is actually the average velocity. So here what we have calculated is the average velocity. V is actually the average velocity. So we can substitute that average velocity itself. And length is 300 meters. And diameter is 0.05. So if you substitute all these values, you will get the pressure drop in Newton per meter square. That is 684288 Newton per meter square. So this is a pressure drop that will be experienced in the pipe of diameter 50 mm and length 300 meters. So then we have to calculate the shear stress at the pipe wall. So we have this equation for calculating shear stress. If you are new to this equation, please watch the video suggested here. So here we have dou P by dou X into R by 2. Dou P is the change in pressure. Dou X is the change in length, that is space, that is the length of the pipeline. R is the radius where we need to calculate the shear stress. So here we can replace this dou P, that is change in pressure, by P2 minus P1 and dou X, that is X2 minus X1. So, and now I have replaced this small r to capital R, because if you are calculating the shear stress at a particular radius small r, we have to use that particular radius. But if you are calculating the shear stress at the wall, the r will become capital R, that is the radius of the pipeline. So that's why I have replaced that small r by capital R. If it is capital R, that means that is the radius of the pipeline itself. If it is small r, that will be some radius in between here. So now we can substitute the values. Before substituting the values, we can invert this P2 and P1 here. So P1 minus P2, because P1 will be the maximum value, pressure 1 will be maximum and pressure 2 will be minimum because of pressure drop. As I have changed that, the sign minus sign will be replaced with plus. So P1 minus P2 divided by X2 minus X1 into R by 2. What is this X2 minus X1? This is the space. This is X1 and this is X2. The point 1 and point 2. Here we are having 300 meters. So that 300 meters length is the X2 minus X1. And P1 minus P2 is the value that we have calculated in the previous stage, that is pressure drop. And R is the radius of the pipeline. Already we know the diameter of the pipeline, that is 0.05, I think. So the pressure drop already we have calculated, the length of the pipeline already given in the problem, radius of the pipeline, that is diameter divided by 2, and the value 2. So if you substitute all these values, we will get the shear stress at the pipe wall, that is 28.512 Newton per meter square. So thank you, hope you have understood this video. If you have any suggestion or queries, please drop in the comments. Thank you.